Yeah, I got it copy. I got you checked. Alright, I've been drinking a little bit, so if y'all run up on me, I'll pull out of the way.
Yeah, I know. It's only my third time at this track. Please, guys, pass high. I'll veer inside wherever you guys stand in line outside, okay? It's a tough track for me. I'm not running 27 seconds fast last time.
Yeah, if you're coming up on...
Yeah, I had beer. No, I had only one today. That's good.
Because the other night I was getting ready to go low. I didn't tell the guy.
I will not touch nobody's car. Just pass high.
If you're coming up on me fast, coming out of a turn, I will go low.
Oh, shit. Don't worry. I'll go low on the straightaway. So you guys pass me on the straightaway. I'll give you room. I'll see you come up on that relative time with that. Trying a new setup, too.
I'll do my best, then I'll pass my recording.
Good to know. Good. Thank you. But I'm still running 29, not 27. And this is a long one. With this new guy, I don't expect we'll have any caution to this. Maybe just change the tires one. That's about it.
Hello, stay low in the back set for you, leader.
Alright, man. I'm spot for him. Appreciate it.
Staying well. Tell them all in front touch.
83 when the Ford gets to you. You mind to let him have it like you did?
10-4.
Appreciate it, thank you. 183 when he gets back to you, do the same thing again.
10-4.
Appreciate it, Jake.
Still on here.
Thanks, man.
No problem. Going low here.
Hey, Steven, when he gets to you, when you get to him, he'll just go down low and let you go by. No problem.
Going low. Come on.
Jacob, why wouldn't you let me buy? Answer me a stupid question.
I didn't let you pass because you didn't get close enough and I was pushing it to stay heavy on the bar.
Yeah, the sportsman, Mike. That's really bad.
You ran up to me, yes. But the one car was coming up quick, so I started pushing it and I pulled away from you. And you were a lap down, so the position really didn't matter.
Yeah, a couple more laps and I would have had you, Jake.
Yeah, I was really on the edge. I was hoping the tires wouldn't give up on me.
Yeah, I hit the wall really hard fairly early on and got like a minute 50 damage.
Yeah, I spent the whole race taking it easy. And that last little, you know, 20 laps there, like I was just pushing it.
Yeah, I had went in late because I realized that I didn't have enough gas. So I got a lap down to you and I passed you. And I think I was about 4 seconds behind you when it ended.
Yeah, once you got to about like 10 seconds behind me, I started reeling it. I only pitted one time the whole race, so I think the winner did the same thing.
Yeah, he pit only one. And I would have done the same thing if I hadn't hit the wall, but I hit the wall so hard that I had to go in and get the damage fixed.
Yeah, when I pitted, I had about 30 seconds of optional, and I stayed and fixed the whole thing.
Yeah, see, this is a place that you can't take your tension off the track, because I was coming through 1 and 2, and I looked up to see if somebody was coming up on me. And when I looked back down, I was headed right into the wall on the exit of 2.
Yeah, that first run, I was doing the same thing. I kept watching my relative, and I, like, smacked the wall a little bit, like, getting 0 points, like, times 2 points a little bit, and then that second round, I only touched the wall, like, once, I think.
Yeah, I hit the wall several times. I ended up, I think, with 8 times damage. 4 times from smacking the wall, and then, you know, 2 here, 2 there.
Anybody's winning. Good race. Congratulations to Klein for winning. That was a good run.
Oh, yeah. Congratulations, Klein. And Jacob, you ran a good race. Like I said, I screwed it up for myself.
I think it would have been a lot different race if you wouldn't have gotten well.
Yeah, I think, Klein, that you and I would have been at least close. But... You know, I did like a nosedive into the wall coming out of 2. I think you might have seen me do it.
Yeah, I've seen it. I mean, you knocked the piss out of it.
Yeah, like I said, I was doing something stupid. I was looking at the relative going through the turn, which you shouldn't friggin' do here.
Yeah, this place is a beast, man. You have to, like, pay attention all the time.
Oh, I know, and going into turn 3, I know better because, you know, you got to pay real close attention in turn 3 and 4. But for some reason, I thought I had the line going good, so I looked at my relative, and next thing I know, I'm just knocking the shit. I'm trying to push the wall out.
Same thing happened with Ray Prima. He asked me why I didn't let him by. And I was like, he was within a second of me, but I was getting ready to let him by, and he missed the exit of the corner, and he lost a whole bunch of time. So I was like, okay, I'm just going to keep running my line.
Yeah, absolutely. Like I said, you know, when people did run up on me, I did move down to let them by. But, you know, if somebody's up behind me within 3 or 4 seconds and they hit the wall, then I'm not going to move.
Yeah. I just looked at the finish order, and he was 93 laps down. He was asking me why I didn't let him by.
Well, you know, when I came up on both you and Klein that one time, of course I was laps down, but you guys moved over to let me by because obviously I had fresh tires and was a lot faster than you guys. But and I'll do the same thing. If I know somebody's got fresh tires or if I know somebody's faster than me, I'll let them by. You know, at the start of the race, I said that because I screwed up and didn't say that and come out of turn 4, went down low, and the leader went down low, and we ended up wrecking. And I apologized to him and told him, hey, I was trying to go low to let you by. And he's like, yeah, I know. I'm not used to that, so I was trying to go low to go around you.
Yeah, anyways, good race, y'all. My first race back in a while, so good race.
Well, good job, Jacob, for your first race back.
Thank you.
And Klein, you ran a hell of a race, brother.